enjoy the sunshine today?
Yes!
Yes, well, I'm from Glasgow, so I feel like I'm on my holidays.
Glaswegians, give a cheer.
Whee!
Yes, I don't know if you've done this. I brought my Factor 20 with me and my case of special brew. I'd like to return from vacation like a true Glaswegian, skint and hallucinating. I'm pregnant. I'm still struggling with that last one, but the night is young, and so is this young buck here, so sorry, sir. And I've got all that ahead of me because I've started noticing myself doing things like my mum, for example, I hold my tits now when I run. Anybody here do that?
Yes.
A few of the men. We know. Well, mother used to do that, and that's really scary because she now holds hers when she walks. I can see that coming. So yes, so my mum, yeah, she's from Belfast and everything, you know, and I do love her, she's fantastic. But she's kind of quite disappointed with me because she's always wanted me to settle down with a nice Irishman. But sadly for her, my fella, ex-fella now actually, was English. Do you have any English in?
Yes.
Yes. Well, you see, I love the English. I shag the English. Well, I figure someone has to. I'm only messing. But when I first met himself, right, I didn't want to upset Mum, so I told her a wee white lie. I told her he was Irish. I told her he was from Ballybuffet in Donegal. I thought she'll like that. I even invented a wee thatched cottage in an Irish scone knitting granny. A scone knitting and jumper baking granny for extra authenticity. And a wee peat fire and a one-eyed dog called Fred there who sang old Irish ballads late at night. Mum loved it. I was quite looking forward to it myself, looking forward to going over for holidays and funerals. The main problem was I had to make him put on an Irish accent whenever Mum was around. And the problem there is he was so bad at it, she just thought he was retarded. So when we broke up, you know, I mean, she still didn't mind, even though he was completely wrong for me. You know, she says, OK, he might have special needs, love, but at least he's Irish. I explained, no one in Scotland speaks Gaelic anymore, apart from a couple of wee guys in the Outer Hebrides who claim to be able to speak a couple of words, but only when they're fished. Although I did this, I did go out with a guy one time who spoke at Wanker, sorry. Suffer from Tourette's when I talk about him. He was dickhead, he was really sorry. He was the only fuck nugget. This is no longer Tourette's actually, this is catharsis. He was the only person I knew who used to watch this at the Gaelic news we had here in Scotland. Do you remember that? A few of you. Do you remember with Postman Pat? Some of you might remember that. Padraig Post, is your main our cat. Because there's certain English words do not translate well into the Gaelic. So if you don't speak Gaelic, like most of us in Scotland don't speak fucking Gaelic, you have to pick around the English word to figure out what's going on. Thankfully in Scotland that's not difficult. So obviously it's the news. Fesco ma, hoo thiri foo thiri choo thiri, Gary Glitter, hoo thiri foo thiri choo thiri. He's been tamping him with his veins again with the two. Gordon Brune, hoo thiri foo thiri choo. He's just fucked, isn't he? He's just fucked. He's almost squatting, really, isn't he? Fuck thiri. The best laugh is what I found in his drawer after we split up, a Gaelic porn film. Neat throat. Treat some fantastic acts coming up for you, so I'll see you all again sometime soon. Good night.